Hey guys, hope you're having a great day as well as a great life.
As well as age. Ooh, cussing out the gate. Goodness gracious, get some soap for that mouth.
Got three more.
Three more.
Don't talk about soap. I got trauma.
God, you can't make me laugh this soon. Riding the storm out. I was trying to read the title for so long. I'm wearing a beanie because I feel like REO Speedwagon deserves a beanie. I've heard of this band a lot. I think somebody tried to have us do like a live version one time of one of their songs.
Yeah, I think Golden Country.
Golden Country. But this might be the first one on the channel.
I think it absolutely is, and I'm super excited. I think the reason we hadn't hit them before is because people always said we had to hit like their earlier, more classic rock stuff, but all their really, really big songs were 80s, so we just took that as like 5% resistance and just moved past it.
Yeah.
But I'm definitely ready to tackle like the demons now.
I am too. I am too. Ready to move past and have a bitchin' time.
Riding
That's
out
my
the
one.
Storm. So we got like two more?
We have one more. Oh. Let's do it. Okay. Ooh. Not where I thought it was going.
Riding the storm out. Get that hand brain popping.
Waiting for the thaw out. On a full moon night in the Rocky Mountain winter. Now wine bottles low.
Dude.
Watching for the snow. I've been thinking lately of what I'm missing in the city.
Oh!
Watching the full moon cross in the range. Riding the storm out. Riding the storm out. Riding the storm out. Riding the storm out. Lady beside me.
Double time snare.
criminal, dude.
Dude, it is the simple things. Like an unidentifiable hum from some cable and the sudden onset syndrome of a tambourine that really make life worth living.
Goodness gracious. My boy needed at least 16 more bars to solo.
For sure.
They took it away from him.
They definitely did. And I bet you in the studio he just kept playing. And they were like, all right, you're done now. And he's like, I'm done when I say I'm done. Dude can rip. This is a great song.
Very clean sounding, too.
Yeah, I mean, there were very few and far between things that I didn't find absolutely pinnacle for this. Like, great guitar riff, really cool vocal lines. Even from the very start, the way it hooks you with, like, that synthy thing, which you're like, oh, I think I know where it's going, and then you don't know where it's going. And then I love, lyrically, when he says, like, right before the first chorus, and he's like, lately I've been thinking about what I've been missing, or, like, back home or whatever. And then he goes, chorus hits, and he goes, I haven't been missing a thing. I was like, that's the sass I'm here for sure.
And I forget what the line was, something about like the moon cross into range or something. It just sounded so cool.
It sounded like some man shit in the woods on a boat maybe,
the whole concept like seems to be like they're in either like the Rocky Mountains or somewhere where you're a little bit more remotely, like, not in the city. And
I was thinking a ship, because riding the storm out, I assume they're on like a boat, like, and there's some storm that's messing with them. Either way, continue.
Oh, it could also be that too. I definitely took it as more of like a snowstorm type of thing, where it's like winter's here, you know, you have some crazy like weather, and we just gotta like ride it out almost.
That's even cooler to me. Huh. Just cool.
Either way, cool concept of just like riding it out, like through like the toughness and not wanting to, and if you had the choice, you wouldn't go back, and you're not like sitting there like whimpering or missing what you had. You're like, no, I'm, for one, I'm good here. For two, like, let's just ride the shit out.
Yeah, it's almost like taking value in the shitty situation. Like, this is not optimal. Like, we are going to have to ride this storm out. But honestly, I'd take this over not riding the storm out.
So it makes your life like what it is. Like,
yeah, that's, it's really cool. And like I said, the guitar was ripping. The drums were really, really fun. The bass was cool. All of it was great. I really loved that guitar line. Like, whatever the rhythm of the guitar line was just such a cool way to like build the song. Didn't ever feel like it got tiring. The only thing I think is maybe at the end when he was doing those like extra high kind of screams, it got a little wavy in the pitch maybe. But like, even that was cool. Like, if you're some mountain man / naval person and you're riding either a liquid storm or a solid snowstorm, like, you can have some wave in your voice. That's cool.
Some waviness, some frailty. I also love how the drummer was not afraid, like you mentioned, to go double time on the snare.
Yeah, in the second verse. Like, what a ballsy move. Like, you don't hear that. Count the number of songs that do that. It's very few.
And usually the songs where you do hear the double time snare, it's usually there's also a lot of other sonic things happening.
Yes.
To where it's building momentum, like, da-da, da-da, da-da. And it's like building stuff up. But there wasn't that many elements happening, like taking a bunch of space. So it's like a very like clean, open room. And then you just have that there propounding it forward still, which made it like feel slightly like less impactful than if you had like a bunch of stuff like where you're building up. But he also wasn't trying to build up per se. He was just trying to have that energy consistently. And I think it just carried through super fucking nicely.
Super great. What are we rating it?
Three. A countdown, sir.
Two. One.
A plus.
Here's what I'm saying. I think this is an A, and you know how I rated the Smith song an A as well?
Yeah.
That Smith song is not an A. We heard that right before this one. In comparison, that song is B+. This is an A, for sure.
I was leaning A for the song overall, but I just liked the guitar work. So, like, I think, like, I was thinking A pretty much the whole time until, like, the ending solo happened. And then I was going to, like, spitefully keep the A because it ended soon. And I was like, that's not fair to him.
It's not fair to him. I'll say my personal preference is this is an A+. But I'm trying to be more like Freedom Shack objectiveness. I'm trying to be like Freedom Shack levels of objective. And I think it's an A in terms of that, like in terms of like the aggregate of music we've heard. But as far as like a song that I'm just going to put on one day, like either at the gym or like, let's say I'm late for a flight and I need to not be late to that flight. This is the song. For sure, this is the song.
Or you're just going through a tough time and you're riding the storm out.
It's a tough time.
And you want like a double time snare to like keep you like moving, not just walking.
Yeah. Yeah,
like you want some pep in your step, your chest a little higher when you're not feeling great. I feel like that could do it.
Yeah, you got a slight cough. This will do it.
Yeah. Either way, let us know where to go next with REO Speedwagon. If there's something else we should do, like, is their '80s stuff good? I get performed really well commercially, so maybe so. I definitely just wanted to hear some of the classic rock side first, but let us know where to go from here.
And with that being said, see you next video.
Peace. Alright guys, thanks so much for watching. If you have not already caught our freaking reaction to the full album for Sheer Heart Attack by Queen, our first Queen album all the way through, go ahead and hit that link here to the Patreon and check that out. Super fun. See you there.
We'll be right back.